Oh, my dear darlings. So, today I have this awesomeness here to show you. And this is the quirky writer, S. And it is a mechanical keyboard that looks like a typewriter. How awesome is that? I don't know about you, but I almost lost my mind when I saw this. It brought so many memories from my childhood. Growing up, my grandma, well, my grandparents, grandma and grandpa, had a typewriter, and it was, I was little, but it was always so fun to just press the keys on their typewriter. So, needless to say, when I saw this keyboard, I was beyond excited. And I did record an unboxing video, but unfortunately, I cannot find the memory card. So, I've been already using this keyboard on my iMac. I've been using it for about a week at least, and I love it. So, the quirky writer has arrived in this box. Well, it had a shipping box as well, but inside that box, there was this box. Pretty packaging. I received the quirky writer as there was a card in the box with a website. I will link it down below, and on that website you can find step by step how to set it up. It was very easy, but first thing that I did was to press on each and every single key. And what that does is make sure to put the keys in place, and the more you use it, the better the keys feel and type. And as you know, if you watch ASMR videos, sound is very important, and I think that this sounds amazing. Even when I use it on a daily basis while I'm on my Mac, I enjoy it quite a lot because I find that this sound, and even the way the keys feel on my fingertips, very relaxing. So, in today's video, I will pretty much give you the basic information on the Corgi Rider S. And if you are interested and you'd like to learn more, then just click in the link. Click on the link down below and find out more. So basically, the Corgi Rider S is a mechanical keyboard that has the capability of connecting to up to 3 devices. And that can be your smartphone, your laptop, tablet, iPad, computer, PC or Mac. And you can connect those devices through Bluetooth or the USB cable that comes in the Corgi Rider S box. I have been using it wirelessly, therefore I have not even removed the plastic. But when I first got it out of the box, I made sure that I charged it. And to do that, you have to use the USB cable provided. And the cable is going to last forever, I can tell you that, because it has this material over the actual cable, the fabric. I don't know what this is called. I feel like the HomePod has that same feel. And what do you do when you get it? You just connect it to your computer and give it a 2-hour charge. And that charge should last you for a month. And the Corgi Rider has a lithium battery. And if you have this connected to your computer and you have it and you're using it with the USB cable, then you have to turn it off because the power comes from your computer. But when you decide to use it wirelessly, then you just turn the switch on and use it through a Bluetooth connection. And I will show you a quick demonstration of how it works. I will not use my Mac or my MacBook because they make more noise than phones and iPad, so I will use my Samsung S9 Plus and my iPad, and I guess my iPhone. Right here we have the on off button. It's on. Oops. And that's the Samsung because I paired it already. There's this toggle button, and what it does is switches between USB and Bluetooth paired devices. Can see right now the Bluetooth devices are connected because there's the green light. It's very difficult to show you this way because I'm not facing the phone and the quirky reader, so I'm just showing I'm in the back. Thank you. Yes, this is the most expensive keyboard that I have ever used, but it is also the coolest. And I think a lot of you will agree with me that it is most definitely an unique gadget. This beauty to a coffee shop with me, and no, it was not Starbucks, and I had my iPad, and I was typing away, and let me tell you, there were a lot of people that were looking at me like, what is that? But unfortunately, only a few approached. They did not want to bother me, but a lot of people looked, and it was so fun. I think this would also be a cool, maybe not really the keyboard that you should take to a library. Thank you all so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. I think I will make a separate video where I will just type something for you. Let me know your thoughts on this. And